Greetings and salutations from the Fat Boys on Tour HQ, a secret bunker location very close to that wonderful dump, Southend on Mud in Essex. But it's where all the magic happens, folks. Now I hope you're all keeping well and staying safe during this difficult time. And we really do appreciate you watching our videos, commenting, subscribing and liking. Thanks again. Now today's walk was actually cancelled because we were basically knackered from all our walks over Eagle Crag and the Fairfield Horseshoe. However, Bert and I looked out of the window across the wonderful Windermere from our YHA location and we saw it was a glorious day. So we decided to take a local bimble up to Wansfell. Now it's a steep start, but it's a wonderful location. So we hope you enjoy the video. I'm also hoping to clear up a few issues that walkers have as to where the actual Wainwright top is. Intrigued? Then keep watching. Today's walk began from the White Lion Hotel in Ambleside, walking up Stockghyll Lane, taking a small detour to the Stockghyll Force waterfall. Now it is a detour, as you should return back to the lane if you want to do it correctly, but we decided to climb over a nearby wall and rejoin Stockghyll Lane near the ascent, which was at our own risk and is not recommended. This meant, for us, that after a few metres along the lane, we started our steep ascent to Wansfell Pike, which is classed as a Birket fell top and often mistaken for the actual Wainwright. Now this turns into quite a bash, ascending 312 metres via a stone staircase path, and I found it hard going on this hot day. Once we reached the top of Wansfell Pike, we took a well-earned break and took in the excellent views before setting off along a ridge to the area known as Baystones. Now a lot of fell walkers used to get confused here as to what little fell top in the area was the actual Wainwright, and that was if they were savvy enough to walk here in the first place. Now that is because there are two classifications of fell top in short proximity to each other here. One is called Wansfell Baystones, which is a Birket top, and believe it or not, the other is called Baystones Wansfell, which is the Wainwright, and is only 0.83 metres higher. But I'm pleased to say it now has a decent cairn on it, and at present there's going to be no confusion. Once Bert and I had finished our little bimble around, bagging all the little bumps that hillbaggers.co.uk may have called a fell, we decided to have a chat about which way to walk back. Now normally walkers just return to Wansfell Pike and drop back down to Ambleside, but we're not normal, as you know. So we decided to drop west towards Round Hill Farm, over rough ground with no path, going through clear gaps and stiles in the walls, as well as farm gates. After arriving at a nice path that runs alongside the gill, we pass High Barn, joining Seathwaite Lane, and then a short part of the Kirkstone Road, eventually getting back to Ambleside and dark liquid salvation in the Golden Rule Pub.
Welcome to place to get with you. Look around, see what you do. Everybody's positive.
Makes me feel fine, blowing through
Well, we hope you enjoyed this short little video about a lovely bimbo up to Wansfell. We certainly enjoyed it on the day, I can tell you, and we thoroughly recommend it to you. Now, don't forget to like it, that's if you like it, and subscribe, and we always love your comments. Now that we're back in the groove and firing on all cylinders, which we're all very pleased about, if you want to keep up with everything Fat Bloke, don't forget to check out the Fat Boys on Tour walking group page on Facebook. Once again, thanks for watching and taking the time to comment. And as always, hopefully one day, we'll see you out there. Cheers.